In round 3, first work one slip stitch in the mark stitch of fabric 1. Two fabrics are connected. Remove the marker and work one chain stitch. Then work for some crochets. Work the first single crochet in the mark stitch. Mark this single crochet. Continue to work 3 more single crochets. For some crochets are done. Then work one slip stitch in the mark stitch of fabric 2. Remove the marker. Work 8 single crochets. Work the first single crochet in the mark stitch. Mark the first single crochet. Continue to work 7 more single crochets. Eight single crochets are done. This short yarn tail may become loose during the crocheting. Just pull it tight. Then work for some crochets in fabric one, namely the middle fabric. For some crochets are done. Tighten the yarn tail. Then work 8 crochets in fabric 3, namely the left fabric. Work the first crochet in this stitch. Continue to work 7 more crochets. Eight single crochets are done. We can see there are three-way shapes between the last stitch and the marked stitch. They are the snip stitch of this fabric, the snip stitch for connection, and the chain stitch. Skip these three-way shapes and work one snip stitch in the marked stitch. Remove the marker and work one snip stitch in the marked stitch. Round 3 is done. The stitches for rounds 4 to 5 are all the same. In rounds 4 to 5, work 1 chain stitch, 24 single crochets, and 1 snip stitch for each round. We'll demonstrate round 4. Work 1 chain stitch first. Work the first single crochet in the marked stitch. Mark the first single crochet. Continue to work single crochets. Pay attention here, we need to skip this V shape, formed by the snip stitch. Remove the marker. Work the fifth single crochet in the marked stitch. Then continue to work single crochets. Finish a total of 24 single crochets. Twenty-four single crochets are done. Remove the marker and work one snip stitch in the marked stitch to join this round. Round 4 is done. In round 5, we don't need to skip any stitch. Work one chain stitch. 24 crochets and 1 slip stitch in turn. Please finish round 5 on your own. Round 5 is done. Stretch the loop and remove the hook. Break yarn, leaving a long yarn tail for sewing. Pull the yarn tail out. Tie knots with every 2 yarn tails and place the yarn tails inside the fabric or cut off excess ends. The coxcomb is completed.